हॅलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर सुनील दत्ता एन कुलकर्णी, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू डिलिव्हर अ व्हिडिओ सेशन ऑन इलेक्ट्रोलक्स रेफ्रिजरेटर अँड लिथियम ब्रोमाइड वॉटर वेपर ॲब्सॉर्प्शन सिस्टीम. नाउ लेट अस सी, ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस व्हिडिओ सेशन स्टुडंट्स विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन the working of Electrolux refrigerator and also explain working of lithium bromide water vapor absorption system. The contents of this video session are the working of Electrolux refrigerator and working of lithium bromide water vapor absorption system. Now in previous sessions we have seen two fluid vapor absorption system. For example, in case of aqua ammonia, we have seen that the ammonia is used as refrigerant and water is used as an absorbent. So there were only two fluids. But in case of Electrolux refrigerator, it is also called as three fluid vapor absorption refrigeration system. So why it is called as three fluid vapor absorption system? Which is the third fluid? Let us think for a while. Now, in case of Electrolux refrigerator, it is called as three fluid absorption system because we use three fluids, like ammonia used as refrigerant, water is used as an absorbent, and hydrogen gas, which is inert gas, which does not take part directly into the refrigeration system, but it is used as a carrier gas. We will see in detail why we use hydrogen particularly in Electrolux refrigerator and how it helps to make the system pumpless. Now let us see, the main purpose of this Electrolux refrigerator is to make the machine noiseless by eliminating the moving part, that is pump. So our objective is to remove the pump from vapor absorption system so that the system will become totally quiet, noiseless. Now let us see, as I have told you, ammonia is used as refrigerant and water is used as absorbent because water has ability to absorb the ammonia readily, which we have already seen in the principle of vapor absorption system. The hydrogen gas is used because it is being the lightest gas. It is used to increase the rate of evaporation of liquid ammonia passing through the evaporator. And this is used in low pressure side of the system. So ammonia gas is used only in the evaporator part. Okay, so we will see how it circulates, where it moves. So let us see the figure of now Electrolux refrigerator. It's a schematic diagram. Now we will see, now if you see this figure, okay, the basic vapor absorption system which we have studied, that is aqua ammonia vapor absorption system, that is same as Electrolux refrigerator, or Electrolux refrigerator is same as vapor absorption system, but only major change in this Electrolux refrigerator is that we are adding one more fluid, that is hydrogen. Okay, now let us see how this particular system will work. So first of all, I will like to tell you is that the basic components of Electrolux refrigerator are evaporator, absorber, generator and condenser. These are the major components of this system as they are for other systems. Now here we have added the hydrogen in the evaporator along with the refrigerant, that is ammonia. The hydrogen gas is also added in the evaporator, or it is, you can say, so in the evaporator we will have two fluids, ammonia plus hydrogen. So total pressure in the evaporator will be partial pressure of ammonia plus partial pressure of hydrogen. Now what is the use of this? Here the main objective of putting ammonia in the evaporator is that when you add the hydrogen in the ammonia, okay, so we can boil off the ammonia at low pressure corresponding to its partial pressure and we can achieve the low temperature in the evaporator, but at the same time the total pressure in the evaporator maintained is more because hydrogen. But however, remember, hydrogen does not absorb any heat. Okay, so when the ammonia liquid will enter into the evaporator where hydrogen is already present, okay, so it will mix with the hydrogen and this ammonia liquid will absorb the heat, and mixture of ammonia and hydrogen is carried due to the pressure difference, okay, to the absorber. And here now only the ammonia vapor are absorbed by the water, whereas the hydrogen gas, which is lighter gas, it flows back to the evaporator. Okay, now whatever strong solution is formed, it will be going to the generator. Now this is carried by gravity, no pump we are using. In earlier figures we have seen the pump is used, but in this Electrolux refrigerator we don't require any pump as such. Okay, it flows by gravity, the strong solution of ammonia and water. And in the generator we can use small lamp, even small spirit lamp. For Electrolux refrigerator was basically a sort of domestic refrigerator which was developed long back, okay, so by Electrolux company. So small lamp is sufficient to supply the heat in the generator where ammonia vapor will be separated. Now of course along with ammonia vapor some water may also be there, so we are separating the water vapor by using a analyzer and rectifier combination, which is called as water separator. Okay, so here analyzer rectifier are shown as water separator. So this water, after separation, the weak solution will go back to the absorber through this pipeline, and only ammonia vapor will go to the condenser where it will get condensed, and this liquid will now go to the evaporator. Okay, now only important thing in case of Electrolux refrigerator which we should remember is that we do not want hydrogen gas to flow to the condenser, or it should flow to the this particular water separator. So these pipelines here I have shown one small, okay, these pipelines are made given little bent, so this acts as a, you may say, liquid seal. So liquid will be always present in the bend, so that there are no chances that hydrogen gas will enter over here, either to the water separator or condenser or even generator, as well as it will only go back to the, it will also not go to the absorber because here it is separated and it will go to the evaporator. So hydrogen moves only from evaporator to absorber, okay, here from evaporator to absorber and absorber to evaporator. That is the only limited circuit for hydrogen. Okay, only ammonia and water, they will be moving through other components. So if you see the explanation which are working, simply gas burner is used here for supplying the heat in the generator, and this particular ammonia vapors are sent to the condenser via rectifier, analyzer or water separator. And then if you don't remove the water vapor, they will enter into the evaporator and cause freezing and choking of the machine. So we separate them and we pass only the ammonia vapor to the condenser where it is condensed, and this weak solution which is left in the generator flows back to the absorber through the heat exchanger, which we have seen, where it gets cooled away by heat to the strong solution going to the generator, okay, by giving away the heat. So return weak solution is hot, which will give the heat to the strong solution going to the generator, so that the amount of heat required in the generator will be less. Okay, so now let us go to the important point, okay, that is next part, lithium bromide water vapor absorption system. Now the major difference between aqua ammonia and lithium bromide water vapor absorption system is that in case of aqua ammonia system, we are using water as absorbent and ammonia as vapor. Whereas in case of lithium bromide water vapor absorption system, lithium bromide salt solution, okay, which is highly hygroscopic, is used as an absorbent, whereas water is used as refrigerant in case of this system. So this is a small beautiful line diagram, schematic diagram of lithium bromide system. The working of this system is exactly same as that of earlier system, but the only important point in case of lithium bromide water vapor absorption system is that here we are using water as the refrigerant. So you cannot use this system for producing temperatures less than 0 or 0 degree Celsius because water will freeze. So usually this system is used in case of large air conditioning application where the required temperatures are ranging from 10 to 20 degree Celsius. Now let us see the construction of this lithium bromide vapor absorption system and working in short. So in case of lithium bromide water vapor absorption system, as you can see here, the absorber and evaporator, they are placed in the single shell, low pressure side. Whereas the condenser and generator, they are also placed in the single shell, okay. Though they are shown separately here, they are also contained in. Now let us see the working. So from the evaporator, okay, whatever liquid refrigerant coming from the condenser is sprayed on the evaporator, okay, coil in the evaporator, through which the chilled water which is to be chilled, I mean the water which is to be chilled is circulated through the coil, and this chilled water is sent for air conditioning purpose or any other application. So this liquid refrigerant is sprayed over the water coil in the evaporator, where this water which is sprayed as a refrigerant will absorb the heat, it will vaporize, and then it will go to the absorber. And here in the absorber, okay, this particular water vapor will be absorbed by a solution of lithium bromide salt. This lithium bromide salt which is coming back from the generator is again sprayed over this, so this will be absorbed. So here we will get now weak solution, because after absorbing the water vapors we get the weak solution which is pumped with the help of absorbent pump in the generator. So just like simple aqua ammonia, we need to remove the heat from this absorber to keep intact the what you can say absorption capacity, and then in the generator we supply the heat with the help of some heat source. So again the water vapors are separated, that is the refrigerant is water, and lithium bromide solution is sent back to the absorber. So then this water vapor will go to the condenser where it is condensed, and then it is sprayed over the evaporator coil. So this completes the working of lithium bromide water absorption system. Now these are the working which I have already explained. This is for your reference, these notes. Normally this system is only used for air conditioning application where you require the positive temperatures. Okay. So now these are the references. Thank you.